Well, Hoover, looking forward to chatting with our next guest. Please welcome Mr. Tom Everett Scott. How are you, man?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing well. Tom, we just bumped in with a clip of That Thing You Do, and you and the original cast decided to do a viewing party to raise money, which is very cool. What made you guys get to decide to get together, and how did it come about?
Well, just last week, I was FaceTiming with Steve Zahn. Me and the rest of the Wonders, we've stayed really good friends over the years. I mean, these guys are like my brothers. And Steve and I were like, let's do something. I mean, what can we do? Can we just, you know, be goofy for the fans? And then we got the group together and we decided to do this commentary watch party. So we're going to Zoom and we're going to put it on YouTube Live, and all the fans and everyone can just press play together, and we're just going to talk about the film.
It still holds up, one of the best films ever. What was it like? Are you keeping in touch with Tom Hanks, especially after he's coming out of Corona?
Well, Tom has been one of the greatest inspirations in my career, and he's been one of the nicest people I've ever had to, you know, work for. He has a, you know, a great family feeling around Playtone. We always see each other at games, baseball games, and different events, and he's just a great guy. I haven't talked to him since he got sick. I've been talking to Colin Hanks, and you know, they're doing great. You know, you saw him on Saturday Night Live last week, so it was good to see him healthy.
With the bald head.
I know. I guess that's for a role. but we're super glad that he and Rita are okay.
Yes, of course. Hey, Tom, I know you're a baseball fan yourself. You just mentioned some baseball. How you been dealing with the season, man, being postponed this year? And do you feel that it could come back and we can maybe salvage it with a half a season? And the frustrating thing is we had the All-Star game here in L.A. this year.
That is pretty I miss baseball so much. I love it. I wish it was here. I wish any sports were here, honestly. I just talked to Bob Melvin, the manager of the Oakland A's. Surprised him on a little interview, because he's a fan of That Thing You Do. And, you know, I don't know. There's all this talk about them getting together in Arizona. There's talk about them being part of an antibody test. I don't know. I just hope that it gets here soon.
What do you think about the game without the fans? I mean, we'd be excited, right, to have anything back. But, I mean, haven't you been listening to the organist from Fenway? It's
yes.
So great online.
How great is that? He comes on every day at 3 p.m. Eastern. He plays his organ. As soon as I saw that, I was like, oh, yes, I'm going to be listening to that.
I want to talk about your new show, Council of Dads. It's a great title, now on NBC. It's based on a true story. Tell me about it.
Okay, so it's based on this book by Bruce Feiler, who it really happened to him. He got osteosarcoma. He thought he was going to die. He's actually still alive, thank goodness. But his book is about him wanting to pass along his values to his children. And the way he did that was he formed a council of men who would be father figures for his children. And so that story was picked up by Tony Phelan and Joan Rader, this married couple writing team that used to show run Grey's Anatomy for like 10 years. This is their show where they took the book and they expanded it. And in their version of the story, me, the dad, does not live. He does die, and then he forms this council. So the series is about this family, and it's a beautiful story. It was a wonderful opportunity for me, you know, to be part of a show. I'm already on a show. I'm sorry, on True TV, and so this was a chance to just do something really, really cool. It's going to be on April 30th. They're going to replay the pilot. The first episode, and then the second episode is going to come on right after it. So 8 Eastern and then 9 Eastern on April 30th on NBC.
Tom, did it make you think, I guess in a weird way, about your own life? Who would be on your council?
I mean,
and who wouldn't? You're like, dude, you're out. You,
right. Yeah, or more like my wife would be like, no, not that guy.
No, not him. Definitely not him.
I absolutely thought about it. I mean, how could you not? You know. So yeah, I mean, there's a couple guys on my list.
And I know you're also a theater guy, Tom, and I understand you didn't warn people that you were naked in a play you once did, right?
I love it.
Yeah, so yes, that's right. Back in like 1999, 2000, I did this off-Broadway play called The Country Club, where I had to be nude on stage. It was the first time I ever had to do this. Mm-hmm. And I warned everyone. I said, come see the play, it's a great play, but just know that I will be naked. And about halfway through the run, like months later, I got so comfortable, I stopped warning people. And One of those people I didn't, I, one of those people I forgot to warn was my mother-in-law.
Oh, no. So
when I came out after the show was over, I was like, hey, what'd you think? And she couldn't even make eye contact with me.
Oh, that's funny.
She still can't to this day. She's like, right. Good to see everybody. Tom, have you kept up with Billy Crudup? Are you watching The Morning Show?
No, I actually haven't seen that. Is that the one that's on Apple?
Yes. He's dominated on there. That thing you do, partner in crime right there. Yeah, you got to binge it.
Okay, I absolutely will. I need to know some things to binge. I've been looking for some stuff.
Well, we appreciate you taking the time to chat with us, man. Congrats on everything. Yeah. And stay safe and God bless. Hopefully we'll see you in person sometime soon.
That'd be great. Great to see you guys. Thank you for having
me. Thanks, Tom.